must say, you've had quite a smashing career in advertising.
Thank you. I like to think I could sell veal to a vegan.
So you did your postgraduate work at Southern Methodist University?
Yep, go meth or go home.
Then you started out writing ad copy for Ogilvy and Mather.
Loved Ogilvy. Mather was a little gropey.
Okay. And then you were with BBDO in New York?
Yep, I was VP BBDO NYC, R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
So why did you leave?
To be completely honest, I was bored. I had knocked it out of the park so many times with the food campaigns, I got pigeonholed. I mean, sure, I'm proud of eggs. They're not just for breakfast anymore, but who wouldn't be?
Good heaven. That was you.
It was a team, but yeah.
Well, I have to tell you, Miss Plunkett, I am very impressed.
Thank you.
You are the most spectacular liar I've ever met in my life.
Excuse me?
I've been in the ad business for over 30 years now. You think I don't know who came up with "they're not just for breakfast anymore"?
I said it was a team.
You are so pathologically shameless, I'm almost tempted to hire you.
Well, as I told Nike, just do it.
Get out.
Thank you for your time.
Declan.
Morning, sir.
I trust everything is up to your standard, sir.
Now, I understand that you made an inquiry about making some structural changes to your suite, Mr. Ward.
Oh, you got the polls. Yes!
A certain member of a certain royal family left more behind than just memories. Yes, you can almost smell the aristocratic DNA from here.
I don't know what that means.
Well, it doesn't matter. Now, I shall be next door, so if you need anything, just press number one on your keypad.
Right. Hey, let me tip you, man.
No, sir, I couldn't.
No, please, stop. People don't think black people
tip. I do this for the love of the job. Well, thank you very much, sir. That would be lovely.
Well, I was going to give it all to you. I was going to give you a certain amount. Sir, that's...
Thank you, sir.
No, thank you.
Life is like a washing machine. You throw everything in, hope it comes out smelling better. And if it doesn't, you put in more soap powder.
What the fuck was that? That's not a saying. That's just instructions how to use a washing machine.
Well, it was, but I was trying to use it for you.
I know how to use a washing machine.
No, it's not about the washing machine, man. It's about life.
Is it, though?
It's a parable.
Because it sounded like washing machine instructions, didn't it? Look at it. It's so grey and I'm damp all the time.
That's England for you. 51 shades of grey.
I'm feeling a bit... I feel a bit beaten down, to be honest, at the moment.
Yes, you've got to look on the bright side. You've got to pull yourself up by your bootstraps. That's what I said to Lucy. I said to her, darling, it's time to get out there, face the world again, a new slate.
Did you tell her the washing machine?
No.
It's not an everyday conversation, a father telling his daughter that the reason he split up with the mother is because he gave her gonorrhea.
I had just come back from a business trip in Thailand, and about 10 days later, your mother started to feel unwell. And this particular strain can only be contracted in Thailand. As
oh
you know, your
God.
Mother has never actually been to Thailand, so she naturally blamed me.
Who else would she blame?
Are you going to finish that pastry, Randy?
No.
No, I mean, Tom and I... It's all completely different. This is a little bit stale.
As he's doing the scene, he's eating a pastry which has some kind of messed up, congealed icing on it.
I hate to say this, but this does look a little bit like gonorrhea.
That was it for me.
I hate to say this, but this does look a little bit like gonorrhea. I hate to say this, because I can't really eat the rest of it, but this does look a little bit like...
It's because I see your eyes, Jane!
I'm fucking acting!
Fuck, don't breathe for me.
Nope.
Can I help you? I doubt it. I'm here for the hot wing eating slash wet t-shirt contest.
Yes, I'm sorry to say there is no hot wing eating slash wet t-shirt contest. You see, your Commander Cove enlisted me to help you conquer your uncontrollable profanity, and we figured that this was the only way to get you here.
Whoa, 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 whoa. No titties?
No titties.
No wings?
No wings.
No titties!
No titties again. My name is Hobson Chips, and I'm British. General Colonel Aladdin.
Aladdin.
General Colonel Aladdin. There are various reports of human rights violations in your country.
Necessarily. I am the president of Wadea's Commission on Human Rights. If there were ever any such violations, I would pick up the phone and call myself.
But you just denying it to yourself doesn't actually alter the fact that there were human rights violations. How does this address the issue?
It does address the facts because of the situation.
There are various allegations that you have had elderly women stripped naked and tied to wild oxen.
That one's true.
Yes. In terms of your... I see we're going to...
I'm going to resort to this. I'm English. Oh, I like to fuck dragons.
I've never actually...
This goes against everything I believe in.
Well, in that case, we're in the same boat, because I don't believe in workplace romances.
What?
You're an extremely attractive woman, headmistress.
You can't win me over that easily, Mr. Middleman.
Having a disability doesn't mean you're not sexy. You are everything I look for in a woman. And more. And less. So, I rush to the wings where Oliver here...
He's fast asleep,
but the show must go on. So I think what I'll do is I'll shout, bang. Well, the cue for the gunshot comes, Oliver falls off his stool, the broom hits the floor, bang. No one ever knew.
Oh, God, my teeth hurt from grinning.
Well, the show must go on.
Now, I assume you spent many years in school.
Yes.
Let's talk about bullying for just a moment.
Bullying? Well, as a matter of fact, I was bullied, yes.
What happened?
Well, actually, I was pretty much tormented on a daily basis by football players in the locker room. Sometimes it crossed a line.
Physically?
Yes.
Emotionally?
Yes.
Sexually?
Yes.
Hello!
Mummy and Daddy, this is the fellow I was telling you about.
How do you do? Wing Commander Edward Hyde Tottingham, RAF retired. This is my wife, Sharon.
Hello.
Would you raise your daughter with a jungle beast in an effort to satisfy your scientific curiosity?
I have crossbred orchids.
Yes, they're lovely. As are you, my darling.
I think the Shih Tzu is a terrific
What's
dog.
That one?
The Shih Tzu.
The Shih Tzu. That's one you don't play around with that name, do you? It doesn't come trippingly off the tongue. Stewardess, can I take a Shih Tzu on my carry-on, or does it have to be stowed?
Yes, that's
So is that a Shih Tzu?
An old joke, but a good one, nevertheless. Yes.
I don't think I ever could get used to being probed and prodded. I told my proctologist once, hey, why don't you take me out to dinner and a movie sometime, you know?
Yes. I remember you said that last year.
Yeah.
Look, I know my job is to translate your vision into the real world, okay?
Right. Yeah.
But the problem is, I don't see a vision. Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, sure.
Do you know how tight my aperture is right now? Have you any idea?
If you're being a smartass, you know what I'm gonna put you across my knee. I want it to be bright.
It's bright. It's brighter than Stephen bloody Hawking in here.
I'm in the bladder management industry. I sell catheters.
It's a growth industry, really, because one in three people over 60 either have a flaccid or a spastic bladder. So, in a sense, every 13.5 seconds. A new incontinent is born, as it were. People like you and I have what they call leakage problems. They can be running, playing tennis, laughing, sneezing, anything. I mean, a good old constipation, you know. You have impacted fecal mass in your rectum. You find that pushing on your bladder.
Might make good dessert talk.
This film is based on probably the largest archaeological dig in modern times. Yeah. So it isn't really just another theory. It's
a lot more than that. Would that change your views at all, knowing that?
Well, yes and no.
And yes being?
There's no yes. I'd say no.
So more no than yes?
Yes, I'd say...
So it's no and no?
It's really just no. There's not no and no, it's no.
Oh, I've got plenty to complain about. Don't get me started. No, no, I've got a 9-year-old dog that needs a new kidney.
I had a bucket of acid thrown in my face.
I haven't had a hot meal in 3 years.
My wife is dead.
So is mine.
Car bomb.
Pneumonia.
Queen Margot, we must speak.
Loyalist, what do you want?
Nice tomatoes.
So, let me just get this straight. You told this girl that you would die just so you could get a slot in the festival.
Yeah. Pretty fucking pathetic, huh?
No, I like it. It shows commitment, not to mention a glimmer of creativity. Oh, don't get me wrong, you're still a cunt, but fuck it, we're here.
Troy Nixon was Leggy's assistant.
Lover.
A companion.
Whatever.
Leggy had quite a stable
of young boys. Oh, yes, he, always loved attractive young men. He always had his finger on the pulse of young boys. Yeah.
They all had strange names like Wild, Damp, Thunder, Clap.
He tended to name them after how they were in bed, you see. You know, like Tommy Wild, Dickie Furious, Jeffrey Willing, Billy Is That It.
We'll stand behind you, Peter. That bitch has threatened our mutant way of life. For too long, we believe in you.
Jim Piddick.